Hi, welcome back to Mechanics and Control of Robotic Manipulator. So I have received a few, you can say, you call feedback or probably concern. So can you actually like show a little more example on, you can say, frame arrangement and all? So in that sense, I have taken three slightly different examples, and I just wanted to demonstrate, or you can say, how to fix the frame arrangement for those given configurations. For beneficial, I have just taken simple 3D of system, but the same procedure you can continue, and you can actually like use MATLAB code which we have discussed. Then you can find the forward kinematic solution, and if you have actually like strictly six equations, six unknowns, even you can find the you call a closed form inverse kinematic solution. However, if you are actually like interested to find the numerical inverse kinematic solution, then you can use it at any point of time. Right. So in that sense, we are actually like trying to see three different example of, you can say, configuration. For that, we will try to arrange a frame for given, you can say, joint axis. Then we will try to derive the DH parameter, you know all. So once we obtain the DH parameter, we need to cross check whether the given DH parameter or obtained DH parameters are actually like correct or wrong. So for that, we will just do the forward kinematic relation. Then we will actually like get the home solution or home position. Then we cross check, right? The same thing we are going to do it here. So the first thing is actually like here, we got the, you call this is 1 R. Okay. So I'll just say this is second R and this is actually like another R. So 3 R configuration, and this is the end effector. So which is actually like, we can say end effector frame. So in that sense, we can actually like start the base frame and then we can go across. So in order to get this very clear, so we are actually like trying to do the frame arrangement best. First start with the line diagram. So I just draw the line diagram. Okay. So I'm just drawing the line diagram and then doing it. Okay. So that is what we are trying to do. So this is actually like line diagram on the centers, and this is the centers. And this is the center, and this is the center like that. So we have a line diagram, and in that we can all assume that this is actually like end, and this is the you can say base, right? So we are trying to find out what is the end effector relation with respect to base frame. So that is what we are interested right now. We'll just go across whatever the you can say joint axis which are given, that first we will fix it. So the joint axis 1, 2, and 3, the end effector frame, fourth one is given. So we'll fix it those things. So in order to make it this, I just rotated towards looking this side. So then this is the way which we can actually like plot it. So we are actually like looking at this way. So in that sense, you can see this is the joint 1, this is joint 2, and this is joint 3, and this is the end effector, you can say axis, or you can say approach axis. So if that is the case, we can actually like use the, you can say frame arrangement policy. So if the, you can say axes are intersecting, then the intersecting point supposed to be one of the frame. And if there are actually like intersecting, but it is not, you can say meeting on one common point, then we have to see how to take it. For example, in this case, so there is one frame here because these two are intersecting, and these two are intersecting one frame here, but these two are actually like non-intersecting, neither intersecting, non-parallel. So then we have to actually like see how to fix it. And if that is the case, first we will see like what are the inputs. So here it is three rotary joints. So the rotary joints, we can actually like see this is a rotating, or you can say circle, that denotes a rotary joint. So in the sense, the positive rotation, which we call theta one, so theta 2 and theta 3 we have written. Since it, the end effector frame is actually like passive, so we have just put it as a point. So now we will actually like fix the frame points. So before that, we will just start with the 0th frame. So for that, we start with the 0th axis. So the conventionally vertical axis all consider as Z0. So that is what we have taken here. So now we fix. So here there is no intersection, so we can start this as the base, and this is the intersecting point, that is 1. And this is actually like neither intersecting nor. So then I can consider this line intersection point as 2. This is 0, and this is 1, and this is 2, and this is 3, and this is 4. Right? So these are the cases which we are actually like trying to see. So now we can actually like go across further. So we'll start first fixing the x-axis. So you know, like x-axis fixing is actually like based on the current z-axis and the you can say further x-axis, in the sense. So current and the next two z-axis will define or decide what would be the current x0 axis or x-axis. In the sense, x0 is depending on z0 and z1. So in this case, z0 and z1 are parallel. So we can take it actually like either of two other orthogonal axes. So I'm taking one of the orthogonal axes here as x0. So which is actually like easiest for further in this particular approach, because I'm actually like assuming that this is actually like my x-axis, because I'm looking at here. So in that sense, that is what I consider as x-axis. That is fine. So which is actually like very much, you can say, suitable further. So now coming to x1. So x1, you can see like z1 and z2 are actually like intersecting and the plane containing this. So now is the z1, like x1 would be plane containing that normal direction. So in the sense, it can actually like go this or this. So we are taking going towards as the x1. The similar way, you can see the plane containing, you can see like the same thing. So the plane containing this is the axis. So towards inside the screen, I consider as x2. There is a reason also, because there are two distance. This distance supposed to be along x2. So that should be positive direction. So that's why x2 consider along the direction. So now coming to x3. So here you can see again plane containing this. So you can go across. So then x3 and x4 we can concentrate. So in the sense, you can see x4 and x0 are parallel, which is actually like easiest. So if I would have started here, then I have to actually like relook at it and I have to actually like modify it. So that's why I've taken x0 as this way. So now coming back to the frame arrangement along with the, you can see other parameter, either it is a joint parameter or the link parameter. So all we have actually fixed, the length D1, D2, A2, D3 and D4 are fixed. So now what we can do, we can actually like try to find out the DH parameter. So it is actually like straightforward. So what is alpha I minus one? So alpha I minus one is the angle between Z, you can say I minus one to ZI. What about, you can say about XI minus one. So similarly, AI minus one is actually like the frame. So I minus one to I, okay. So the distance along, you can say XI minus one. Right. So the similar way, if you go with the theta I, so theta I is actually like angle between, so XI minus one to XI, but about, so ZI. So similarly, DI can be written as, you can say the I minus one to I along ZI. So based on this, if you obtain, you can see like the DH parameter can be obtained like this. So for example, you take the first frame, you can say like a joint parameter. So you can see like you can say alpha here in this case about x0, these two are parallel. So it is 0 degree or 0 radian. And you can see like along x0, there is no distance, so zero. Now coming to, you can see the theta. So here actually like x0 and x1 are parallel. However, the z1 is active joint. So that's why x1, if these two are actually like, for example, you assume this is what x1, then this rotation would be coming. So in the sense, theta 1 plus pi by 2 would have come. We will see that example in upcoming slides, but right now you can take it this one. So now fourth one is D, so DI. So now you can see the 0 to 1, there is a distance along z1. It's the positive direction. So that is what D1, right? The same way, when you come to the second frame, you can see like z1 and z2 are actually like not parallel. So with respect to x1, you can see like this is the positive rotation. It is rotating 90 degree. So that is what, and there is no distance along x1, so that is zero. And this is active joint, so that is why theta 2, and d2 is the along d2. The similar way, you can go with the third frame and fourth frame, and this is the DH parameter. Once you obtain the DH parameter, what you can do, you can actually like substitute individual, you can say transformation matrix, and then you get the forward kinematic solution and then cross check. So now what one can see, first of all, We'll assume that the home position where theta 1 equal to 0, theta 2 equal to 0, and theta 3 equal to 0. If that is the case, what would be the position of, you can say, 4 with respect to 0? So that would be along x, so that would be a2. Along y, the y is this direction. So along y, you can see like a d4, right? So which is actually like a d4 minus d2 supposed to be, because this d2 is actually like positive direction, sorry, this direction, and d4 the other direction. So d4 minus d2. And the third, which is actually like along, is z0, which you can see like a d1 plus d3, right? So, and coming back to the approach, or you can say normal sliding and approach, the normal is actually like, you can see x4 projected on 0th frame, that would give z1, 0, 0. So in this case, if you look at it, so this you have actually like taken. So now in this case, the x is here and this is y4. So y4 projected on, you can say 0th frame, that would be giving 0, 0, minus 1. And z4 projected on, you can say, what you call 0th frame. So that would be giving 0, 1, 0, right? So now we can actually like check what would be the forward kinematic solution. So the forward kinematic solution is actually like obtained here. It is very lengthy. That's why this particular configuration is not preferred. Even then, inverse kinematic solution is not so easy. It is actually like very complex. So the numerical is easy, but closed form is actually like little trivial. That's why this particular configuration is not preferred. Anyway, we will substitute theta 1, theta 2, theta 3, all 0. So what happened? This goes 0, and this also goes 0, and this also goes 0, and this become 1, and this becomes 0. Since A2 is coming, so that is what we also obtain. So coming back to the second one, you can see this become 1. And this becomes 0 in the sense D4 would be stay back, okay? And D2, this one become 1, and this becomes 0, and this also becomes 0. This is D4 minus D2, so that is what we also obtain. And the third one, you can see like this become actually like 1, this becomes 0, this becomes 0 in the sense D1 plus D3, right? So that is what we also obtain. So coming back to the orientation, so the a normal vector, you can see this become 1, this becomes 0, this 0, this also 0, this also 0 in the sense, so 1, 0, 0, that is what we also obtain. And this becomes 0, this becomes 0, this become minus 1, 0, 0, minus 1, and this become 0, and this become 1, and this becomes 0, so 0, 1, 0. So this is what we also obtain. So in the sense, whatever we obtain, the DH parameter are right or correct. And then we can go across further, you can see differential kinematics or even dynamic analysis or further closed loop and all. Okay, so this is one such case. You can now, you can understand how the frame has actually like fixed, how the DH parameter uptake. The same way we can actually like go further. So this is another example, which is very common because, so these two are actually like in plane, but in theoretically what we did actually like this. So I'll actually like show this way. So this is the way we actually like did. So this is Z4 and this is Z3 and this is Z2 and this is Z1 and this is actually like Z0. So this frame arrangement also like valid for this. Okay. However, we use this distance also in consideration and then we will do it. Again, we are going to look at it in this way. Okay. So now in that sense, we can actually like look at it. So this is the line diagram, which is actually like this line, this line, this line, and this line, and this line. We are actually like seeing it from this view. So now we can actually like fix the joints. So this is actually like first rotary joint and this second rotary, and this is the third rotary, and this is the end effector point. Okay. So now this is the base and this is the end. So we are trying to see. So now based on this, we can actually like fix. First, we can actually like see what are the joint parameters. These are actually like rotary joint. All three are theta 1, theta 2, theta 3. And then we have, you can say, frame arrangement. In this sense, it is actually like intersecting. So this is the point and this is the case, right? But you can see like this distance who would cover. So we will fix it. This is actually like third and this is four. And in this case, this is two. And this is actually like one. And this is actually like a zero. Okay, so that is the way we are actually like fixing it. And now you can see like X0 how we fix the last case. The same way we can go. So like that we can actually like go across. But when we come to, you can say X3, you can see like this is a plane containing. And if we start here, this distance somebody has to cover, right? So that's why we are actually like trying to take this as the third frame. So in that sense, X3 we can actually like see. So this is the plane containing. So the normal to this. So I can take X3 actually like vertically up or down. But here we have taken vertically up. And in that case, X4 also can be continued. So now based on this, we fix all the distances. So D1, D2, D3, D4 and A2 and all. So now we can obtain the DH parameter. So as I already mentioned, for example, in this case, the third frame, if you look at it, so X2 and X3 are actually like, you can see X2 and X3 are actually like non-parallel and it is actually like 90 degree apart. In addition to that, the theta 3 also like active joints. That's why you can see theta 3 plus pi by 2 has come. And further, you can see like the second frame to the third frame, which is actually like opposite direction along Z3. That's why it is minus D3. Okay, so the joint distance can be negative. However, the link length cannot be negative. That is what we all discuss. So in that case, this is actually like valid, right? So again, once you obtain the DH parameter, you need to cross check whether the solutions are right or whether the DH parameter what we obtained and the frame arrangement what we have done is right or wrong. So for that, we substitute these into an individual transformation matrix. Finally, you multiply and you get the fourth transformation matrix with respect to zero. So let us first see what is the x-axis displacement here. So in this sense, x-axis displacement, this is the direction. So it is A2 and you can see D4, right? And the y-axis, this is the y-axis. Then again, it is so D2 minus, you can say D3. And what happened to what you call Z? So that would be simply D1, right? So that is the case. And orientation side, so X4 you projected on 0th frame, that would be 0, 0, 1. And if you look at it, so this is the y-axis and this is the so x. So then what would be the y? So y would be in this case, right? So that is what we can actually like see. So y would be actually like projected just opposite direction of your original y. So in the sense 0 minus 1, 0. And the z is actually like, you can see that is projected on x. So 1, 0, 0, right? So we'll come back here, the kinematic solution, which is we obtained. So now you substitute theta 1, theta 2, theta 3. So why we are taking it? This is the home position, which we framed based on this particular frame arrangement. So if we freeze this, what is the distance covered from fourth to zero and what are the orientation? That is what we are trying to cross check. So if that is the case, so this becomes zero, this also becomes zero. And you can see like this become one. So this also become one in the sense D4 plus A2. So that is what we also get it, right? And further, you can see this becomes zero, this also becomes zero, and this become actually like one, this become actually like one, D3 minus D2. So that is, okay, this is the positive direction. So D3 minus D2, that is also we obtain. And finally, you can see these all zero, so then D1. So that is what we obtain. Related to orientation, you can see very clearly, this is one, this is zero, zero. So that is what we also obtain. And this is 0 minus 1, 0. That is also we obtain. And this is 1, 0, 0. That is also we obtain. So like that, you can cross-check. Further, by looking this diagram, so you can see like this is the same distance covered. So in the sense, you can take D2 and D3 as same. If you take it, that is same. So what becomes? This becomes 0, right? So that is what. So you can see these two will not be appear. So then it is actually like what we derive the similar notations which we are getting it, right? So now if you take cos theta 1 common, so then you can see D4 cos theta 1 plus cos theta 2 plus theta 3 plus A2 cos theta 2 would be as the internal part. So that is actually like we can see. So anyway, I've tried to see it in simulation later on. So right now we'll go to the third configuration. Third configuration is actually like one R replaced with the prismatic joint. So this is the prismatic joint. So now in the sense the end effector frame need not to be separated. So now we will actually like go across. So we look at it here. This is the way it is. So I have actually like simplified. This is the point third. This is the end and this is the base. And you can see like there is one joint which is rotary. And this is another joint. This is also rotary, but this is a translation joint. So that is what we have actually like shown. So theta 1, theta 2 and D3 are the variable. And now you can actually fix it the same way. So we can actually start with X0 and then X1. But X2, you can see like this is the plane containing, right? So now either this or this supposed to be X2. So we are taking upward direction. So the similar way we can keep it X3 also. So now based on this, we can actually like obtain the DH parameter. So you can actually like clearly you can see. So the X1 and X2 are actually like 90 degree with respect to Z2. So that's why this is although active, but it is having 90 degree offset all the time. So that is what we have actually like seen. So again, the same way we substitute that. So now what would be the, so this is Y0. So what would be the X side? So X side displacement is actually like D3. So Y side displacement is minus D2. Z is actually like D1, right? And the orientation side, you can see like, so 0, 0, 1, okay? And in this case, we can actually like 0, minus 1, 0, and 1, 0, 0, right? So like that, we can actually like go across. So now we can actually like see the same thing is happening. Yes, so if you substitute theta 1, theta 2, theta 3, all like theta 1 and theta 2 are 0, this become 1, this become actually like 0, and this become actually like 0, and this become 1. So you can see like D3 minus D2 and D1, right? So here again, you can see like this become 1, so 0, 0, 1, and this become 0 minus 1, 0, and this become 1, 0, 0. So this is what we also obtain. So in the sense, your kinematic relations or frame arrangement and obtained DH parameter are, you can say, valid. So further, in order to get much more clarity, so I have taken the same thing. So individual DH matrix as a DH table here, and we are trying to derive it. So for example, whatever we obtained, that I actually like given it here. So now we can actually like see it. So the same thing, I'm trying to do it as a forward kinematic solution. And you can see like each forward kinematic solution is obtained. So now you can actually like see this is the final equation which we obtained. This is the position vector and this is the normal and this is sliding and approach. The same thing you can go with the version 2, which is you can say two axes are parallel. So this is another case which we can actually like see. So you can see this is a DH table which we obtained from the frame arrangement, and then we substitute and you can see like this is the individual transformation matrices and this is the final matrix, and this is the, you can say, position vector of end effector frame with respect to base. So now we assume that I already said if I actually like take it D3 equal to D2, so then you can actually like see it, which is very simple equation. At the end you will get it, so you can actually like see it. So you can see, right? So like you can see like cos theta 1 and sin theta 1 is common, and this is actually like obtained, right? So like that we can actually like see, and this is actually like valid. So in the sense, whatever I drawn in the frame arrangement in the very beginning, 3 are serial manipulator, that is what we are also finally getting it, right? So now this is the case, and the third one, the RP. So this is also, we can actually like consider D2 as P0. So in the sense, it is actually like on the same, but here we have considered D2 is non-zero. So in that sense, you can see like this is the final position vector, normal, sliding and approach vector, right? If you assume D2 is zero, so then that would give a very simplified version. So that is also like you can see. So I'll just check it for you. And you can actually like say it. So this original source code, you can find it in the NPTEL lecture notes, and then you can actually like find it, okay? So now you can see like it is very straightforward, right? So even the inverse kinematics is actually like very easy. For example, y divided by x, px by py, that would be tan in, you can say tan theta 1, right? So once you obtain, then you can see like z minus d1, okay? So whole divided by anyone, you can actually like take it. So with respect to, so theta one, so then that would give theta two, and you square and add all these three. So then you will get, you can say d3 in the form straightforward, right? So these all actually like can be done. So I hope you are actually like clear on this. So I'll go back to the slide. I'll just give a small input further. So I'll just show like one additional. So for example, now here, this is actually like this way. So you want to make it, so I can actually like make it another way of the same 3R configuration, where this is the rotary joint. So in the sense, first like this, the second one and third one, three mutually perpendicular axis. So this is very close to, you call the spherical robot, but this also like will give, you can say a good 3D work volume, but this is another way. But this equation is actually like slightly, you call non-trivial one. That's why people really don't bother to use this. But this is one another, really they don't allow to use this, because this configuration, although it is actually like giving three mutual, but the two R is actually like a parallel, that will give a better one. Even the two R parallel is the other way around also, we can do it. So for example, I assume that this is the starting point. So I assume that this is the starting point. So this is the first rotary, which is actually like rotating this. And this is the second, which is actually like revolving. And the third, which is actually like connected here. So that is again coming back like this. So these two are parallel and this is actually like perpendicular. So this distance is D and this distance is A. So this will also like give another configuration. So where first joint and third joint is parallel and the second joint is perpendicular. But this will give one of the popular, we call compliant configuration. So this is also like a very popular, as similar to this. So these are actually like other way around. So even some people actually like go with so vertical this way. So two parallel and the third, which is actually like, you can see the third is actually like vertical. So it is something like a SCARA, the first two, and the third one is actually like rotating. In that case also, this will give 3D, but the work volume is actually like very small, and the complex equations. But these two are actually like a very much preferred one. That's why I just wanted to give this input. So with that, I'm actually like closing this particular short video. I hope you have actually like learned something. If you have any doubt, you please post an email or probably post it to me. And any of you follow the NPTEL lecture notes, then lecture videos also, then you will get little more, you can say improved, you can say learning, because that will give little detail how the frame arrangement, everything. Since it is a supplement, so I have gone a little faster, but anyhow, you can make it happen. Okay. Thank you then. Bye. Take care.